I stopped to cool my heels today at Gulargambone on the Castlereagh, where shady gum trees bend and sway and life drifts gently by. And I found a place to sit and dream where the low bridge crossed a shallow stream. The world to me would suddenly seem as far away as the sky. Well, I thought that I should be wetting a line. If only I had a bit more time. You know, that's a common excuse of mine for things that I never do. Because life rolls at relentless pace for us runners in the human race. The time we borrow, we don't replace or follow our wishes through. Well, I saw how the town had suffered hard by the empty pump in the garage yard. And the peeling paint on the store facade still wanted some extra care. But those corrugated iron birds, which along the roadside reoccurred, they said more to me than could 1,000 words about the people there. See, their tin wings flap for miles around, with beaks that shriek without a sound, and feet that will never touch the ground upon their iron stands. But their hearts are real. Their hearts are shared with those who love that town and cared enough to come together prepared to build them with their hands. And that showed me that the ties there were strong. And lives are easily swept along when people to a place really belong and not merely reside. Because our lives are just dreams that we fulfill. And dreams can drift away until they're anchored by a strength of will that holds them deep inside. So I followed those birds to that little town and I found the time to wander around. I found a place to lay my worries down beside the sandy stream. And I tell myself that I'll go back there one day. To Gulargambone on the Castlereagh. And that's another thing I always say. Still, they showed me that it doesn't hurt to dream.